All right, so in this video, we're going to be tackling this really cool cinematic movie intro text design. You can works for a lot of things, but it's very typical for movie intros. So you can go check it out on my Instagram as well if you want to see the loop some more. It's right here. You can check it out. Also, you can see my other work and also send me some of your work if you've done the renders from the tutorials. So let's get into this. So this is all that's in the scene. It's very, very simple. If you want to go ahead and download this project file on Gumroad for $1, if you want to see how I built up the scene, if you missed something, you can go get that. So let's clear out this scene and start a new one. So general discard changes. So first off, we're going to add some text. So we're going to go here, text, and we're going to go over here. Right here on alignment, we're going to put both of them at center. So it's right here in the center of our scene. And I'm going to give it B-L-E-N-D. On the text, just like that. And let's add the geometry. So let's just extrude it a little bit like that. And we need, very important, make sure you bevel it at least by one, because when the light's going around, the light is going to catch this curve. It's going to bounce right off of it. Otherwise, you're not really going to see that light bounce and catch that curve in a really cool cinematic way. All right, next I'm going to hit the tilde key, go to the very top, and I'm going to add my camera just like this. Boom. So I want a light to be going around it to be sort of hitting the edges. So we're going to be having a light follow a circle curve. So very simple. Add your circle, then add your light. On the light, click on the constraints down here, add object constraint, follow path, and select the circle. And then we can take the circle, bring it out just like that. Then I'm going to hit tab and select these points, and I'm going to bring them in so that they're very close to the text. Just like we want. So we're going to select this edge just like that. So now the light is going to be going around just like that. Then we need to animate it. So I want this to be 120 frames for now. And let's click right click, insert keyframe, go to the very end, and I'm going to click 100, insert keyframe. So now our light is going to be going around our object, and you can see so right now we're in cycles. I'm going to be switching to Eevee right now. Boom. So now you can see our light is going around our text. So first I'm going to go to my world settings and make my background all the way to black. And let's take this text really quickly and add a metallic shader to it. So click new, make it metallic. So that's all we need to do for now. We can already see a little bit of shine already with this Eevee and bloom. If you don't have bloom on, go to your Eevee settings and turn bloom on. Also, very important, screen space reflections. So now we have bloom. So what we need to do is take our light and up the brightness. I'm going to give it 50 for right now. And let's watch it go around our text in a really cool way. Right now it's actually splashing under the edge. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take the curve and I'm going to bring it a little bit behind and also scale it up a little bit. So now you can see it's even cooler, much more cinematic. It's just catching that silhouette. And let's go in our point light, give it a blue color, really nice, and make it a strength of 100. So now we have this really, really cool text. And a really fun thing what you can do is you can take the metallic shader, make it even less rough, and you can just catch only those edges. But I'm going to keep it fairly rough for now. Let's go ahead and add some shading fun to this. So let's go to the shading tab here. I'm gonna go to look dev mode so I can see everything that's going on. So what we're gonna do is we are gonna add a color ramp right here to the roughness. And of course, very standard, we're gonna add a noise texture. So add that noise texture right here. What we're gonna do is we're gonna add a mapping node just right here. And we're gonna add a texture coordinate. The reason why we're doing this is because we want the object coordinate, which will help wrap the text, the texture around the text very consistently. So we're going to add that object right there. And so now if we play with the roughness, you can kind of see it working right here. So we can, all right, so now we have that. Let's go ahead and add a bump node. So we're going to add a little bit of bump to our geometry. And let's also get this color ramp, bring it back to the edge, plug the color into the height, and plug the noise texture as well into the height. So now we have this. Let's bring up the detail. Let's go to look dev and bring the strength down a little bit. So what I want to do, first I'm going to kill the bloom. What I want to do is flatten out some areas. So all I'm going to do is take it like this, or color ramp on the white section. For you, it may be the black section, but I want it to eat into the text. So now that looks really, really good. So now it's doing that. We can go back to the rendered view and see how that looks. So it looks all right, starting to play with, kind of messing with how it looks. So we're just going to take off the color ramp, off the roughness for now, and play with that. So like that, we're going to take our point light as well and brighten it up to 200%. So now we have this looking pretty cool. Now what we want to do is add a little bit more interesting things to this. Right now you can just kill it right now and just render this, and it's a really cool render, but I want to add some really fun stuff to this. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to hit B for box select, select this much right here, duplicate it so that we can play with telling it where to go. So we're going to add an emission shader to this. I do this quite a bit. It's one of my favorite things to do here in Blender. We're going to add a mix shader, and as well as having this emission shader down here, plug it in, make it red, and plug the color ramp into the mix shader, which has these noise texture stuff plugged into it as well, so we can have some consistency. So now we have this, we can play with the color ramp till it fixes in. So it looks like I may need to bring the white this direction. Okay, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to flip the color ramp and bring the black portion. Perfect, that's what we need. So bring the black portion in and until it just kind of seeps into the spots that you want it to glow, as well as I'm going to take the strength, give it a strength of 20. There we go. And I'm going to go and turn bloom back on so we get that really pretty bloom. So I think that's really good. Perfect. So we're going to animate that bloom in just a second. So now we have, if we press play, this really awesome animation. So all we have to do is animate both the strength of the light and our bloom. So for now, not bloom, sorry, the emission shader. So I'm going to go back to the shading tab, and I'm just going to give the strength of 0 for now. So let's take the point light here, give a strength of 0. So what we're going to do is make sure in your preferences, your default interpolation is on Bezier. So what we're going to do, it's a strength of 0. Let's hit the little keyframe and go to frame 20 here and give it a strength of 200, just like that. Insert keyframe. So what that's going to do, let's actually drag it over to say frame 40. That looks good. So now when we go, it turns on. And then right here at frame 100, maybe 95, hit the keyframe button again, go to the very end, power of 0. So now we've made it animate in and out. So let's just watch that really quick. Turns on, goes around a little bit, and then turns off. So that's all we need to do for animation of that. Now all we need to do is animate the glow. So I'm going to go over to the shading, click on our text here. So now we have the strength. So I believe the strength we had was at 20. Yep. So I'm going to delete that keyframe really quick, go to 0. Let's wait till it goes in like that, maybe right here to the middle of our timeline. Insert keyframe. I'm going to drag this keyframe back and then go to say 51, strength of 20. Insert keyframe, go to right here, and then strength of 0, insert keyframe. So it should just go glow in and back out. So if we watch it, just like that. And that is the animation. Pretty, pretty simple. And you can also add other lights and things like that and have a lot of fun and get really creative. But that's how I did this design. Let me show you how to export this really quick. You're going to go to PNG, click FFmpeg video, save it wherever you want. On encoding, go to this to MP4. Make sure it's on H.264 and change to high quality, render animation, and there you go. So there you go. I hope you enjoyed this animation. I hope you learned something, had some fun with this, and thanks for watching.